वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, साई राम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। हाउ आर यू ऑल? ऑल आर वेल, फॉलोइंग द इंस्ट्रक्शन, हेल्पिंग योर पेरेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, स्टडिंग एंड डूइंग द वर्क। येस, वेरी गुड। You all are doing very hard, right? I want you to clap for yourself. I am also doing clapping for you. You must also do clap for yourself. Yes. So, I welcome you in your environmental studies period. Today we are going to study EST. And how many chapters we have finished? Just tell me. We are having two books in EST. Yes? Remember or forgot? Remember, yes. How many chapters we have finished? Total 3 chapters. We have completed total 3 chapters. Yes? Now we will start one more chapter from the book New Getting Ahead Towards Social Studies. Before that, I want you to remember which chapter, what is the name of the first chapter in EST's Social Studies. Tell me the name of the chapter in New Getting Ahead in Social Studies. What is the name of the first chapter? The name of the first chapter was, tell me, what is the name of the first chapter? The Earth or what? The Globe. Yes, the globe, the model of Earth. Yes, very nice. You all have remembered. Yes, but before starting the new chapter, chapter 2, I want you to look at some points which is related from chapter 1, and those points are related with chapter 2 also. So we are going to read those points and understand those points before starting our chapter 2. Alright children, now I am showing you some points which first I will read and explain to you, then you will also read. Alright, and you all are having notebook and pen with you. Notebook may be any rough notebook or your practice notebook which you have made. And how to start today's chapter? First of all, by writing the date, then subject, then name of the book, and then chapter 2. And I am going to tell you the name of the chapter after these points. First we read the points and then I am going to tell you the name of the chapter 2. Okay, shall we start? Yes. We have seen that the globe is small model of Earth. The globe is a small model of Earth. It is most accurate way of looking at the size, shape and location of the places on the earth. Yes, in our first chapter we studied that globe is a small model of earth and it is the most accurate way of looking the size, shape and location of the places on globe. But do you think we can carry all the time globe with us? Just think on it. it is not possible to carry globe all the time with us. So it has several shortcomings. It has several shortcomings means yes children, means disadvantages. What disadvantages? Shortcoming means disadvantages. All right. Now, what are these disadvantages or what are the shortcomings of using globe? It is difficult to carry globe around. It is difficult to carry globe means we cannot put the globe in our pocket and move here and there. No, it is not possible. We cannot carry the globe all the time. It is not possible to see all the part of Earth's surface at the same time. It is not possible to see all the parts of Earth's surface at the same time. As globe is a small model of Earth, globe is also meant like Earth. It is also round. Yes or no? And you know that only we will see one side of the globe at one time, and when we are supposed to see the other side, we have to rotate the globe. We have to rotate the globe to see the other side of the globe of the Earth. So it is not possible to see all the parts of the Earth's surface at the same time. Next, it cannot show detailed information. It cannot show detailed information. We cannot see, we cannot write detail on globe. Yes, children. To avoid all these problems, we normally use map instead of globe. Understand, children? So, what was our third point? Our third point is we cannot show or we cannot read the detailed information. It means to get detailed information, we have to make a huge huge globe. Yes, if we want to write detailed information, or whosoever is making globe wants to give detailed information about the particular place or country or continent or sea, river or anything. So for that detailed information, they have to make a huge globe so that they can give the detailed information. So that also can't be possible. So it cannot show the detailed information. So to avoid such problems, we normally use map instead of globe. We can put a map, we can fold a map and put it in our pocket. We can fold a map and put it in our book. We can fold a map and easily put it on in a bag. But we cannot put globe all the time in our pocket and travel here and there. No, it is not possible. Understood? This much, have you understood? Say yes or no. I'm not able to listen. Just speak loudly, yes or no? Yes, now I'm getting your voice, yes. So, we normally use map. What we normally use? Map. So, the name of our next chapter is map. The name of our second chapter, from new getting ahead towards social studies, is map. What is the name of our chapter? Map. Now we will study about map. In first chapter we study about globe, and in this chapter we study about map. Now what is a map? Is there any answer from your side? What is a map? We will study. See, this is the picture of a world map. See, oceans are there, continents are there, different countries are there, name of the countries are given, sea is also mentioned, different colors showing the particular different things. See, Arctic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic, America, North America, South America, see, India is also there. So many. This is a world map. Okay. In globe, we only see one part at a time, and for the other part, we have to rotate the globe. But we can see all the things on map at a same time. Understood? Now, a map is a drawing of Earth's surface. What? A map is a drawing of Earth's surface, or it is a part of it. On a flat surface, generally on a sheet of paper. A map is a drawing of Earth's surface, or it is a part of it, on a flat surface. Map is on a flat surface, right? And globe is round, such as on a sheet of paper. Map is always on a sheet of paper, and map is a drawing of Earth's surface. Map are much more convenient than globe. We can carry the map easily. Map are more convenient than globe. It is the representation of Earth drawn on a flat surface, but there are some errors in shape and size of the landmass in the map. Map is a representation of Earth. Map, repeat with me, map is the representation of Earth drawn on a flat surface, drawn on a flat surface. If somebody asks you what is a map, then what do you reply? You will say map is a representation of Earth surface on a sheet of paper. But there are some errors also in the shape and size of land masses. We are humans, right? We cannot make accurate landmass, accurate shape, accurate size. There are some minor mistakes, some minor errors are there, which is common. Alright. So there are some errors also in the shape and size of the landmass in the map. All right, children. Now we have different types of map. What do we have? We have different types of maps. Now you wonder that maps are also of type, different types. Yes, map is of different types. It can be shown, it can be drawn to show the whole world. Map can be drawn to show the whole world or a single continent, a country, a city or your neighborhood. Even your school can also be drawn in any size. Map can be drawn to show the whole world. As one map I have shown you, it shows the whole world. Or how many continents are there? Tell me, how many continents are there? Yes, the map can be of a single continent. A map can be of single country. A map can be of any state. A map can be of any city, any of your neighborhood, or even of your school. And it can be drawn in any size. Second point, a larger area covered by map, the more will be the errors in it. See, the larger area covered by map, the larger area covered by map, the more will be errors in it. The more will be errors in it because it will not accurate, the landmass is not accurate. That's why some errors are there. A map of your neighborhood can be drawn accurately as it covers small area. The map which is made for small area can be accurate somehow because the area covered in that map is small. Right, children? So the map can be a world map, the map can be of single continent, single country, state, even your neighborhood. The larger the area covered by map, the more will be the errors. And the smaller area covered, the accuracy in the map. Got it? Now we have a wall map. What we have? A wall map which can be hang on wall. A wall map of the world can be several times of its size and shows many more detail. It can be easily rolled up and folded and carried. A wall map, whenever we meet in school, I will definitely show you a wall map. Alright, a wall map of the world. Wall map can also be of world map. It can be of map of any particular country. It may be the map of any state. Okay, so what is a wall map? A wall map of the world can several times of its size and shows many more details. It can be easily rolled up, folded and carried away because it is a map. So we can easily roll it, fold it and carry. All right. Now this is a wall map. See, This is a world map, and it can be hang. It can be hang on a wall. See, details are written. It is not visible, but details are written. Details are written here. So we can give the detail information on the world, on the wall map. WALL wall map. We can give the detailed information on wall map because the size of this map is big, large. This is the map of the world. Understood? Next. Now we have atlas. Have you heard this word before? Atlas. This word, atlas, ATLAS, atlas. No, this also I will show you. This is a book of maps. What is atlas? A book of map is called atlas. See, this is a book. This is a book called Atlas. Name is written here. It is Atlas. What is Atlas? A book of map is called Atlas. A book of map is called Atlas. Turn the pages of Atlas and look at the different maps in the book. When we turn the pages of this book, of this atlas book, we come to know that there are different maps in this book. There are different types of map in this book. Here in atlas, you will find variety of maps in it. When we open this book is full of maps. Variety of maps. Okay, what is atlas? A book of map. A book of maps is called atlas. What is atlas? A book of map is called atlas. Now, there are generally two types of map. One is political map and other is physical map. First is political map and physical map. Alright, children. Map showing boundaries, map showing boundaries of countries, states and important cities are known as political map. What is political map? Political map shows boundaries of countries, state and important cities. That map is known as political map. The map showing the natural features. Of the land, such as mountains, rivers, plains. That is called physical map. Understood? The map which shows the boundaries of countries, states and important cities are called political map, and the map will shows the natural features of land such as mountains, rivers and plains are called physical map. Understood? Now, there are few maps showing the crops grown, minerals, rainfall, roads, railways, air routes, etc. There are several maps which shows the crops grown in particular area in the country or in any particular state, any particular region, the minerals found in this particular mineral found in this country or in that countries, which state heavy rainfall is found in which countries, in which state, in which region, what type of roads are there, railway routes are divided, air routes are divided, so many kinds of map. But basically there are two types of map. First is political map and second is physical map. What is the spelling of political map? POLITICAL, political. What is the spelling of political? POLITICAL. What is the spelling of physical? PHYSICAL. PHYSICAL, physical map. Till here you have understood. Now I will show you the pictures of maps, from which you come to know more about political map, physical map and others. Till here all have written the important points and all have understood. Yes, so you are ready for the map. Yes, I'm going to show you. See children, when first of all I have shown the cover of the atlas book, right? Yes or no? See this. This is atlas. This is atlas. Now, whenever we open that book, whenever we open any book, we have contents. We have contents. Contents means index. What we are going to study in this book, we have content. So, in that book, in atlas also, we are having contents. So, it has n number of maps. See, variety of maps. See, the contents. India map, state map, world map. See, in the map of India, location, extent, political map, physical map. Map showing rivers, lake, map showing soils, map showing forest, rainfall, climate, wildlife, irrigation, population, major crops, railways, roadways, air transport, water transport, minerals grown, cotton, textile and so many industries. In state map, various different types of state maps are there, political, physical map, both are there. Union territory map is there. In world map is also political, physical. Asia map, political, physical map. Different countries map is also there. And continents also there. So there are so many different types of map in a book of atlas. And what is atlas? A book of maps is called atlas. Now I am showing you the world map. What is this? World map. In this map, air route is showing. These lines, are you able to see? Are you able to see? The lines are drawn here. These are the international air routes. These are international air routes. These are showing the air routes. In map, we can also find air routes. All right, this is the map of the world. This is the physical map. This is the physical map because it doesn't have any boundaries. Any boundaries. So it is a physical map. It is a physical map. Next is Asia's map. Next is Asia. India is in which continent? India is in which continent? Asia. So this is the map of Asia. This is the political map. This is the political map. How can you say that this map is a political map? How? How can you say that this map is political map? Because this map has boundaries. Boundaries of a countries. And important cities are also there. Yes or no? See. Let's take an example of India itself. It has boundary, a national boundary of India. Yes, it divides one country, the boundary divides one country to other. It has important cities. You can see on map, Delhi is there and Chennai is there, Bangalore is there, Mumbai is there, Calcutta is there. So that means important cities are also on this map. So this map is a political map. Very good. This map, see, this is also the map of Asia. This is also the map of Asia. Seeing this map, what do you feel? Is this a political map or this is a physical map? You are going to tell me. Looking at this map, what do you feel? Is this map a political map or a physical map? See. Yes, this is a physical map because it is only showing the landmass or natural feature. It is only showing the natural feature. It is only showing the feature of land. This is which map? This is the map of a which country? India. Yes. And now tell me whether this is a political map or a physical map. This is a political map. Why political? Because it is showing the boundaries of state and the national boundary which divides India to other country. It also showing the important states. Yes, it also showing the important state. It is showing the national boundaries of a country. It is showing the state boundaries of the state. It is showing the important cities. So this is our political map. This is our political map of India. And this is the physical map. This is the physical map which is only showing the landmass, which doesn't have any boundary, any state boundary. Okay. Now you can easily differentiate between political map and physical map. Yes, one interesting thing I want to tell you that, see, wherever dark green color is used, that is the area which is more green, and the brown color area is showing the hilly region. The brown color area is showing the hilly region. See the air routes and sea routes. This map show the air routes and sea routes. See, here is one reference, a box written reference. See, for Air India. Air India is a, what is Air India? See, the dotted lines these type of lines are used for showing the routes of Air India. This plain line is used to show the Indian Airlines. This dot shows the national airports. Only national, which the planes run between the states only. This show the international airport, means we can take international flight from international airport. This dash is sea routes. This dash is used for sea routes. Now we will see. See, children. See, we have Delhi International Airport. We have Mumbai International Airport. Chennai International Airport. See, this dark color filled spot shows the international airport. And these unfilled dot shows the national airports. This also we can find on map. See how interesting and useful the maps are. Isn't you feel so? See, these are showing the routes in Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal. These are the sea routes. These are the sea routes. Yes, children. How interesting the maps are. Now, this shows. See, this line is used for Central Railways, Eastern Railway, and so on. In map, we can see the railway routes also. The national railway routes we can find on map also. This map shows the road and water ways. This map shows the road and water ways. This map shows the mineral grown. See, here are reference. Reference means we always use some kinds of symbols. We always use some kind of symbols for showing the thing. Let me tell you that we cannot write here. See, suppose I am taking the example of this particular area. Here are so many spots, so many stars, so many dots, or red dot, blue dot, or any other shapes are there. We cannot write the names everywhere of that particular thing. So we have to give a particular symbol to a particular name thing. So only we have to draw that shape. We have to draw a shape. An explanation is given here. Explanation of that particular shape is given here. There we only have to draw the what? We only have to draw the shape. See, mineral grown, mineral found are also shown in the map. This is this map is showing the agriculture. This map is showing agriculture, agriculture grown. This blue, peach color shows pulses. This dot bajra, that lines are showing maize. In which area we found, they only have to draw the symbol. Wheat grown, rice, jowar, ravi, ragi, sugarcane, cotton, jute, tobacco. See, all these things we can find on map. Alright children, so this map chapter is very interesting. Further, in next video we will complete this chapter. Till here, you all have understood? I hope you all have understood, and revise it once again by watching the video again and write down the important points. Okay? And in next video we will also do the revision of what we have studied today. All right? Till then, thank you and Sai Ram. Show me your smile.